If you found out that you were in the Matrix and was given a choice like Neo, would you have picked the blue pill or the red pill? At some point, we've all considered the question, is this world real or are we living in a simulation? And as AI and technology become more advanced, this scenario seems more and more likely. So in this video, we're going to try and figure out if there is any scientific evidence behind these theories and if we're all actually living inside a computer simulation. In recent years, a number of notable physicists and philosophers have talked about the possibility that we don't live in a so-called base universe, but rather a simulation. Neil deGrasse Tyson, for example, believes the likelihood is actually quite high, suggesting there's a 50-50 chance. Elon Musk has gone even further and suggested that there's actually only a 1 in a billion chance that we aren't merely existing in a construct. No one is saying that we're stored as battery cells like in the Matrix, but there are two popular theories for how our existence might not be what it seems. The first is that we exist in a universe that has been created in a laboratory, and that we're basically living in a petri dish. We ourselves are learning so much about the origins of the universe and the Big Bang that it's not too far a stretch to consider the possibility of recreating it under controlled conditions. If a superintelligence had decided to do so, there would be no way for us to see the reality outside. Creating an artificial Big Bang would mean the resulting universe would be filled with matter and energy, just like the bigger universe that it was created in. In fact, it would likely have its own bubble of space-time around it and lose all contact and reliance on the outside. If this was the case, then we would be just as real as the super-intelligent beings who created us. The second and more common idea is that rather than being made of matter, we are, in fact, virtual simulations. It's not such a far-fetched thought the more you look into it. When you play The Sims, do your characters have a consciousness? And are they aware that they exist solely on your computer? Of course, for our world to exist in such a way would require far more computing power and understanding of AI, but it's not beyond the realms of possibility. We already make simulations of our own. Whether it's medical uses for surgery, astronomical projections to understand space, or artificial beings created simply for our own enjoyment. In this scenario, our brains would just be lines of code creating simulated responses to simulated stimuli. Perhaps the most worrying thought is that unlike in the Matrix, there would be no way for us to escape into the real world, because no part of us would exist as normal matter. Furthermore, it raises the question of why we were created in the first place. Was it an experiment to see how societies developed, or are we just the pawns being played in a game? Regardless, if this was the case, it doesn't make any difference to our own perspective of existence. Objects are still objects, pain feels like pain, and we still have a finite amount of time to accomplish whatever we set our simulated minds to. But an experiment carried out by researchers at Oxford University may have ruled out this idea. They found that gravitational anomalies, in particular a quantum phenomenon that occurs in metals, is impossible to create by algorithms and a computer because of its complexity. It seems that to do this, it would require far more computational knowledge than is currently thought to be possible. But does that really prove anything? Philosopher Nick Bostrom explained that the chances of our lives being in simulations are dictated by three ideas. First, that civilizations never reached the point of being capable of creating such a construct and would likely destroy themselves before it was a possibility. Second, that any civilization that does reach the technological stage where it's possible would choose not to, perhaps on ethical grounds. Or third, that there's a high probability that we actually do live in a simulation. There's no clear reason why the first two would be the case, which would leave us with the third. But how do you prove it from inside the system? Some scientists have proposed that if this were a fabrication created by a code, there would be shortcuts taken, similar to the glitches in the Matrix. Others believe that the signs are already here. The universe all around us looks so perfect in so many ways, and the competing forces seem pre-designed for life to develop. So, is this just a coincidence, or a clue that a higher power is at work? At this point, there's no way to know for sure, but next time you think that you experienced deja vu, or even the Mandela effect, you might just have found your answer. Let us know what you think in the comments below. Thanks for watching! Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click that bell icon to get notifications for our future episodes. See you next time!